This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The New Zealand Defence Force Maori, Te Op Kaatua o Aotearoa, Line of Defence of New Zealand, consists of three services, the New Zealand Army, the Royal New Zealand Air Force, and the Royal New Zealand Navy, and is commanded and headed by the Chief of Defence Force CDF. As of 2016, the Commander-in-Chief of the NZDF was Dame Patsy Reddy, Governor-General of New Zealand, who exercised power on the advice of the Minister of Defence, Gerry Brownlee. Under the Defence Act 1990, the Chief of Defence Force is Lieutenant-General Tim Keating, who previously served in the capacity of Vice Chief of Defence Force, having been appointed to his current position on 31 January 2014. Brownlee was appointed Minister of Defence as part of a cabinet reshuffle following the 2014 New Zealand general election, replacing the now Minister of Health, Jonathan Coleman. New Zealand's armed forces have three defence policy objectives: to defend New Zealand against low-level threats, to contribute to regional security, and to play a part in global security efforts. New Zealand considers its own national defence needs to be modest, due to its geographical isolation and benign relationships with neighbours. As of December 2015, 167 NZDF personnel are deployed overseas on operations and UN missions in the South Pacific, Asia, Africa, Antarctica and Middle East areas, and over 200 on other overseas engagements or exercises. Contents: 1. History of the Armed Services. 11. Militia. 1845-1886-12. Volunteers. 1858-1909-13. 3. Colonial Defence Force. 1862-1867-131. Authorised units by July 1863. 132. Defence Review, March 1865. 14. Evolution of Volunteers and Militia. 15. Defence Act 1909. 16. Separate Services from 1909. 2. Higher Direction of the Armed Services. 21. Joint Forces Headquarters. 22. Senior Officers. 3. Branches. 31. Army. 32. Navy. 33. Air Force. 4. Foreign Defense Relations. 5. See also. 6. Notes. 7. References. 8. External links. History of the Armed Services. See also: Military History of New Zealand Militia 1845-1886. After the Treaty of Waitangi in 1840, New Zealand's security was dependent on British Imperial troops deployed from Australia and other parts of the Empire. By 1841, the settlers, particularly those in the New Zealand Company settlement of Wellington, were calling for local militia to be formed. In 1843, a local militia had been formed in Wellington without official sanction. This prompted the Chief Police Magistrate Major Matthew Richmond to order its immediate disbandment. Richmond also dispatched 53 soldiers from the 96th Regiment from Auckland to Wellington. These calls for a militia continued to grow with the Wairau affray. The calls eventually lead to a bill being introduced to the Legislative Assembly in 1844. Those present noted their disapproval of the bill, unanimously deferring it for 6 months. On the 22nd of March 1845, the Flagstaff War broke out, which proved to be the catalyst for passing the bill. In 1844, a select committee of the House of Commons had recommended that a militia, composed of both settlers and native Maori, and a permanent native force be set up. On 25 March 1845, the Militia Ordinance was passed into law. 26 officers were appointed in Auckland, thereby forming the start of New Zealand's own defence force. Major Richmond was appointed commander of the Wellington Battalion of the Militia. The newspaper article of the time notes that Wellington had a mounted volunteer corps. The Nelson Militia were formed about the end of May. In June 1845, 75 members of the Auckland Militia under Lieutenant Figg became the first unit to support British Imperial troops in the Flagstaff War, serving as pioneers. 7 militia were wounded in action between 30 June and 1 July 1845. 1. A man named Riley, later died of his wounds. The Auckland Militia was disbanded in August or early September 1845 because of budgetary constraints. Disbandment of the Nelson and Wellington militias followed, much to the dismay of their supporters. Those at Nelson under Captain Greenwood decided, regardless of pay or not, to continue training. Trouble in the Hutt Valley, near Wellington, in early March 1846 prompted the new Lieutenant Governor George Grey to proclaim martial law and call out the Hutt Militia. Following on from this, the local paper noted that the No. 1 Company of the Wellington Militia had been called out, while the troops stationed in the town had been in the Hutt. The paper further noted that Grey intended to maintain two companies of militia in Wellington as problems continued in The area at least 160 militia remained. These were supplemented by volunteers, and Maori warriors from the Te Aro Pa on 28 October 1846. With the passing of the Armed Constabulary Ordinance in 1846, a fresh call was made by Mr. Donnelly of the legislature to do away with the militia because of its expense. However, the cost to Britain of maintaining a military force in New Zealand was considerable, prompting a dispatch on 24 November 1846 from Right Hon. Earl Grey to advise Lieutenant Governor George Grey that the formation of a well-organized militia and of a force of natives in the service of Her Majesty would appear to be the measures most likely to be successfully adopted. Further pressure in the early 1850s from Britain for removing their forces prompted pleas for them to remain, as the militia were deemed insufficient for the purpose. 1854 brought a new threat to the attention of the colony, because up to that time the military focus had been upon internal conflicts between settlers and the native population. War had broken out between Russia and Turkey. This war began to involve the major European powers and exposed New Zealand and Australia to a possible external threat from Russian naval forces. Parliament discussed providing guns at ports around the country for use in the event of a war with a foreign power. By 1858, attention had swung back to local issues with a land dispute in New Plymouth, prompting Governor Thomas Gore Brown to call out its militia under Captain Charles Brown. A prelude to what was to become the First Taranaki War and a period of conflict in the North Island until 1872, Parliament revised and expanded the Militia Ordinance, replacing it with the Militia Act 1858. Some of the main changes were clauses enabling volunteers to be included under such terms and conditions as the Governor may specify. The Act also outlined the purposes under which militia could be called upon, including invasion. Debates in Parliament had included expressions of concern about Russian naval expansion in the Northern Pacific, pointed out that the sole naval defence consisted of one 24-gun frigate, and the time it would take for Britain to come to the colony's aid. British Imperial troops remained in New Zealand until February 1870, during the later stage of the New Zealand Wars, by which time settler units had replaced them. The Defence Act 1886 reclassified the militia as volunteers. These were the forerunners of the Territorial's Volunteers 1858-1909. Although there were informal volunteer units as early as 1845, the appropriate approval and regulation of the units did not occur until the Militia Act 1858. Those who signed up for these units were exempt from militia duty, but had to be prepared to serve anywhere in New Zealand. One of the earliest gazetted units, 13 January 1859, was the Taranaki Volunteer Rifle Company. To the Volunteer Rifle Corps were added Volunteer Artillery Corps in mid-1859. The first of these Volunteer Artillery Corps were based in Auckland by late 1859. The number of volunteer units were so great that Captain H. C. Balnevis was appointed Deputy Adjutant General, based at Auckland. Colonial Defence Force 1862-1867. In 1863, the government passed the Colonial Defence Force Act 1862, creating the first regular force. This was to be a mounted body of not more than 500 troops, with both Maori and settlers, and costing no more than £30,000 per annum. All were volunteers and expected to serve for 3 years. Formation of the first unit did not begin until early April 1863, with 100 men being sought at New Plymouth under Captain Atkinson. Hawke's Bay was to have the next unit by late April. Papers were reporting few had enlisted in New Plymouth. Formation of an Auckland unit under Colonel Nixon commenced in July, and by the 14th had 30 men. Authorized units by July 1863. Commander, Major General Galloway. Location, authorized actual commander, Auckland 150, Lieutenant Colonel Marmaduke George Nixon. Ahuriri, Hawke's Bay 100,100, Major George Stoddart Whitmore. New Plymouth 100, Captain Harry Albert Atkinson. Otago 50. Mr. Brannigan. Wairarapa 50, Wellington 100, James Townsend Edwards. By October 1863 there was no Wairarapa-based defence force, and 50 were based in Whanganui. The Otago force had earlier been moved to Wellington, with further Otago volunteers heading for the Auckland and Hawke's Bay units. The total defence force numbered 375 by 3 November 1863. In October 1864 the government decided to reduce the numbers in the Colonial Defence Force to 75, with 3 three units of 25 members each in Wellington, Hawke's Bay and Taranaki. By this time there were about 10,000 British Imperial troops in New Zealand, supplemented by about as many New Zealand volunteer and militia forces. There were calls, particularly from South Island papers, for the British Imperial troops to be replaced by local forces. Parliamentary debates in late 1864 also supported this view, especially as the cost of maintaining the Imperial troops was becoming a greater financial burden on the Colony Defence Review, March 1865. At the request of the Governor in January 1865, a formal statement on the defence of the colony was presented on 20 March 1865. This proposed an armed constabulary force supported by friendly natives, volunteer units, and militia as the case may require be established to take the place of the Imperial troops. The proposed force was to consist of 1,350 Europeans and 150 Maori, 1,500 in total. They were to be divided into 30 companies of 50 men each, based as follows: province location number Auckland Queen's Redoubt South, between the Waikato and Waipa Rivers 6 from the Bluff to Pukorokoro 3 in reserve at Papakura or vicinity 3 Tauranga 1. Taranaki and Wellington, Taranaki and Whanganui districts 12, Wellington 1, Hawke's Bay, Napier 4. The total defence budget, which included purchasing a steamer for use on the Waikato, Patea, and Whanganui rivers, was £187,000 per annum. The budget's focus was solely on internal conflict. The issue of external conflict did not begin to resurface until the following year, with thought being given again to coastal defences. The Colonial Defence Force was disbanded in October 1867 by the Armed Constabulary Act 1867. Its members transferred to the Armed Constabulary. Evolution of volunteers and militia from 1863 to 1867. Forest Ranger volunteer units were formed, tasked with searching out Maori war parties, acting as scouts, and protecting lines of communication. They arose out of the need to prevent ambushes and random attacks on civilians near forest areas. The rangers were well armed and more highly paid. These units used guerrilla-style tactics, moving through areas under cover of darkness and ambushing war parties. The Forest Rangers were disbanded on 1 October 1867. See New Zealand Police. Alongside the militia and the British Imperial Forces were the Armed Constabulary. The Armed Constabulary were formed in 1846 with the passage of the Armed Constabulary Ordinance. The Constabulary's role was both regular law enforcement and during the New Zealand War's militia support from 1867 to 1886. The Armed Constabulary were the only permanent force in New Zealand in 1886. The militia functions of the Armed Constabulary were transferred to the New Zealand Permanent Militia by the Defence Act 1886. Lieutenant Colonel John Roberts was the permanent militia's first commander from January 1887 to his retirement in 1888. Lieutenant Richard Alexander Dick Henderson, New Zealand Medical Corps, carrying a wounded soldier on a donkey during the Battle of Gallipoli. Defence Act 1909. The Defence Act 1909 replaced the volunteer forces with a territorial force and compulsory military training, a regime that remained until the late 1960s, with breaks from 1918 to 1921, 1930 to 194, and 194 to 1948 separate services from 1909. This section needs additional citations for verification. Please help improve this article by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. February 2012. Learn how and when to remove this template message. See New Zealand Army, Royal New Zealand Air Force, and Royal New Zealand Navy. Independent New Zealand Armed Forces developed in the early 20th century. The Royal New Zealand Navy was the last to emerge as an independent service in 1941. Prior to that time, it had been the New Zealand Division of the Royal Navy. New Zealand forces served alongside the British and other Empire and Commonwealth nations in World War I and World War II. The fall of Singapore in 1942 showed that Britain could no longer protect its far-flung dominions. Closer military ties were therefore necessary for New Zealand's defence. With United States entering the war, they were an obvious choice. Links with Australia had also been developed earlier. Both nations sent troops to the Anglo-Boer War, and New Zealand officer candidates had trained at Australia's Royal Military College, Duntroon, since 1911, a practice that continues to this day. A combined Australian and New Zealand Army Corps ANZAC was formed for the Gallipoli campaign during World War I, and its exploits are key events in the military history of both countries. The NZDF came into existence under the Defence Act 1990 under previous legislation. The Three services were part of the Ministry of Defence post 1990. The Ministry of Defence is a separate, policy-making body under a Secretary of Defence, equal in status to the Chief of Defence Force. Higher direction of the armed services. A new HQ NZDF facility was opened by Prime Minister Helen Clark in March 2007. The new facility on Aitken Street in the Wellington CBD replaced the premises on Stout Street that had been the headquarters of NZDF for nearly 75 years. The Aitken Street facility is home to around 900 employees of the NZDF, the New Zealand Security Intelligence Service, and the New Zealand Ministry of Defence. HQ NZDF operates as the administrative and support headquarters for the New Zealand Defence Force, with operational forces under the separate administrative command and control of HQ JFNZ Joint Forces Headquarters. The operational forces of the three services are directed from Headquarters Joint Forces New Zealand opposite Trentham Military Camp in Upper Hutt. HQ JFNZ was established at Trentham on 1 July 2001 from this building, a former NZ government computer centre that used to house the Army's Land Command, the Air Component Commander, Maritime Component Commander, and Land Component Commander Exercise Command over their forces. Commander Joint Forces New Zealand COM JFNZ controls all overseas operational deployments and most overseas exercises. Senior officers as of 2016, Chief of Defence Force Lieutenant-General Tim Keating, Vice Chief of Defence Force Air Vice Marshal Kevin Short, Commander Joint Forces New Zealand Major General Tim Gall, Chief of Navy Rear Admiral John Martin, Chief of Army Major General Peter Kelly, Chief of Air Force Air Vice Marshal Tony Davies. Special Operations Component Commander Unnamed NZSAS Colonel, Maritime Component Commander Commodore John Campbell, Land Component Commander Brigadier Michael Shapland, Air Component Commander Air Commodore Darren Webb, Deputy Chief of Navy Commodore Wayne Phil McKee, Deputy Chief of Air Force Air Commodore Mark Brunton. The Defence Force created a joint service corporate services organisation known as the Joint Logistics and Support Organisation JLSO in the 2000s, which later became Defence Shared Services following the establishment of Special Operations Command on 1 July 2015. The new position of Special Operations Component Commander was created. This officer reports to the Commander Joint Forces New Zealand, and is of equivalent status to the Maritime, Land and Air Component Commanders branches. This section needs additional citations for verification. Please help improve this article by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. February 2012. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Army. Two soldiers from the Queen Alexandra's Mounted Rifles during an exercise in 2010. Main article, New Zealand Army. A New Zealand Army NZLAV at Te Kapo Military Camp. New Zealand's Army has 4,584 full-time and 1,671 part-time troops. They are organized as light infantry and motorized infantry, equipped with 102 Canadian manufactured LAV-3 light armored vehicles NZLAV. There are also armored reconnaissance, artillery, logistics, communications, medical and intelligence elements. The New Zealand Special Air Service is the NZDF's special forces capability, which operates in both conventional warfare and counter-terrorist roles. The corps and regiments of the New Zealand Army include, Royal New Zealand Infantry Regiment, Royal New Zealand Armoured Corps, Royal Regiment of New Zealand Artillery Corps of Royal New Zealand Engineers, Royal New Zealand Corps of Signals, Royal New Zealand Army Logistic Regiment, Royal New Zealand Army Medical Corps, Royal New Zealand Army Nursing Corps, Royal New Zealand Army Dental Corps. Corps of Royal New Zealand Military Police, New Zealand Intelligence Corps, New Zealand Army Legal Services, Navy HMNZS Te Kaha in Cook Strait along with other RNZN ships. Main article, Royal New Zealand Navy. The Royal New Zealand Navy RNZN has 2,132 full-time and 435 part-time sailors. The RNZN possess two Anzac-class frigates, developed in conjunction with Australia, based on the German Miko 200 design. Eight other vessels are in use, consisting of patrol vessels and logistics vessels. In 2010, the RNZN completed the acquisition of seven new vessels, one large multi-role vessel named the HMNZS Canterbury, two offshore patrol vessels, and four inshore patrol vessels. All of these vessels were acquired under Project Protector, and were built to commercial, not naval, standards. Air Force ARNZAF Boeing 757, two Lockheed P-3K Orions and a Lockheed C-130H Hercules. Companies in Formation. Main article, Royal New Zealand Air Force. The Royal New Zealand Air Force RNZAF has 2,403 full-time and 212 part-time airmen and airwomen. The RNZAF consists of 51 aircraft, consisting of P-3 Orion Maritime Patrol aircraft and Lockheed C-130 Hercules and other transport aircraft. The NEA Industries NH-90 operates in a medium utility role, and the AgustaWestland A-109 operates the light utility helicopter role. In addition to the main training platform RNZAF, primary flight training occurs in Beechcraft T-6 Texan IIs, before moving onto the Beechcraft King Air. The RNZAF does not have air combat capabilities following the retirement without replacement of its air combat force of A-4 Skyhawks in December 2001. The RNZAF maintains some form of minor strike capability, with the P-3 Orion being able to drop small, unguided bombs. Foreign Defence Relations. New Zealand and Australian military personnel boarding a United States Navy helicopter during a humanitarian aid mission to the Solomon Islands in 2007. See also, Foreign Relations of New Zealand. New Zealand states it maintains a credible minimum force, although critics including the New Zealand National Party while in opposition maintain that the country's defense forces have fallen below this standard, with a claimed area of direct strategic concern that extends from Australia to Southeast Asia to the South Pacific, and with defense expenditures that total around 1% of GDP. New Zealand necessarily places substantial reliance on co-operating with other countries, particularly Australia, acknowledging the need to improve its defense capabilities, the government in 2005 announced. The Defence Sustainability Initiative allocating an additional $46 billion New Zealand dollars over 10 years to modernise the country's defence equipment and infrastructure and increase its military personnel. The funding represented a 51% increase in defence spending since the Labour government took office in 1999. New Zealand is an active participant in multilateral peacekeeping. It has taken a leading role in peacekeeping in the Solomon Islands, and the neighbouring island of Bougainville. New Zealand has contributed to United Nations and other peacekeeping operations in Angola, Cambodia, Somalia, Lebanon and the former Yugoslavia. It also participated in the Multilateral Interception Force in the Persian Gulf. New Zealand has an ongoing peacekeeping commitment to East Timor, where it participated in the INTERFET, UNTAET and UMAMET missions from 1999 to 2002. At one point over 1,000 NZDF personnel were in East Timor. The deployment included the vessels HMNZS Canterbury, Te Kaha and Endeavour, six Iroquois helicopters, two C-130 Hercules and an infantry battalion. In response to renewed conflict in 2006, more troops were deployed as part of an international force. New Zealand has participated in two NATO-led coalitions, SFOR in the former Yugoslavia until December 2004 and an ongoing one in Afghanistan, which took over from a US-led coalition in 2006. New Zealand also participated in the European Union EUFOR operation in the former Yugoslavia from December 2004 until New Zealand ended its 15-year continuous contribution there on 30 June 2007. As of December 2015, New Zealand has 167 personnel deployed across the globe. These deployments are to Afghanistan 8, Antarctica 8, South Korea 5, Iraq 106, Middle East 8, Sinai 26, South Sudan 3 and the United Arab Emirates 11-209. NZDF personnel are on other deployments and exercises. New Zealand shares training facilities, personnel exchanges, and joint exercises with the Philippines, Thailand, Indonesia, Papua New Guinea, Brunei, Tonga, and South Pacific states. It exercises with its five power defense arrangements partners, Australia, the United Kingdom, Malaysia, and Singapore. New Zealand military personnel participate in training exercises, conferences and visits as part of military diplomacy. New Zealand is a signatory of the ANZUS Treaty, a defense pact between New Zealand, Australia and the United States dating from 1951 after the 1986 anti-nuclear legislation that refused access of nuclear-powered or armed vessels to ports. The USA withdrew its obligations to New Zealand under ANZUS, and ANZUS exercises are now bilateral between Australia and the United States under anti-nuclear legislation. Any ship must declare whether it is nuclear-propelled or carrying nuclear weapons before entering New Zealand waters. Due to the US policy at that time of neither confirm nor deny, ship visits ceased, although NZ and the USA remained good friends despite the presidential directive of 27 September 1991 that removed removed tactical nuclear weapons from U.S. surface ships, attack submarines, and naval aircraft. Ship visits have not resumed despite signs of rapprochement in recent years. Military relationships with the U.S. remain limited. Two members of the New Zealand Provincial Reconstruction Team in Afghanistan during 2009. The NZDF served alongside NATO-led forces in Afghanistan in the first decade of the 21st century, and in 2004 the NZSAS was awarded a Presidential Unit Citation by U.S. President George W. Bush for extraordinary heroism in action in 2008. U.S. Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice during a visit to New Zealand said, "New Zealand is now a friend and an ally. HMNZS Te Kaha and HMNZS Endeavour and the South Korean destroyer Rocks Cho Young at RIMPAC 2012. New Zealand is a member of the ABCA Army's Standardization Program, the Naval AUSCANNZUKUS Forum, the Air and Space Interoperability Council ASIC, the former ASCC, which, among other tasks, allocates NATO reporting names and other Western Five Eyes fora for sharing signals intelligence information and achieving interoperability with like-minded armed forces, such as the Technical Cooperation Program TTCPC. Also list of New Zealand military bases. List of individual weapons of the New Zealand Armed Forces. New Zealand Defence College. Current Royal New Zealand Navy ships. List of ships of the Royal New Zealand Navy. Royal New Zealand Navy plans. List of aircraft of the RNZAF and RNZN. List of squadrons of the RNZAF. New Zealand Cadet Forces. Notes Carat AB 2016 Defence White Paper PDF 8 June 2016 retrieved 8 June 2016. Issue 104, 28 July 1843, p. Volume 2, Issue 51, 27 September 1845, page 3. Carat Port Nicholson, Nelson Examiner and New Zealand Chronicle, Volume 4, Issue 188, 11 October 1845, page 127. Carat Nelson Militia, Nelson Examiner and New Zealand Chronicle, Volume 4, Issue 187, 4 October 1845, page 122. Carat Editorial, New Zealand Spectator and Cook's Strait Guardian, Volume 2, Issue 74, 7 March 1846, page 2. Carat Editorial, New Zealand Spectator and Cook's Strait Guardian, Volume 2, Issue 75, 14 March 1846, page 2. Carat Port Nicholson, New Zealander, Volume 1, Issue 49, 9 May 1846, page 3. Carat Port Nicholson, New Zealander, Volume 2, Issue 56, 27 June 1846, page 3. Carat Legislative Council, New Zealander, Volume 2, Issue 74, 31 October 1846, page 2. Carat Military, New Zealander, Volume 3, Issue 119, 21 July 1847, page 3. Carat Withdrawal of the Troops, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 6, Issue 433, 22 August 1851, page 2. Carat Letters to the Editor. Our Defences, Nelson Examiner and New Zealand Chronicle, Volume 13, Issue 639, 3 June 1854, page 5. Carat Proceedings of the General Assembly, Taranaki Herald, Volume 5, Issue 211, 16 August 1856, page 2. Carat Proclamation, Taranaki Herald, Volume 6, Issue 288, 6 February February 1858, page 3. Carat Arts of the General Assembly, Colonist, Issue 84, 10 August 1858, page 4. Carat British Troops in New Zealand, Te Ara Encyclopedia of New Zealand, Terragov TNZ, 22 April 2009, retrieved 24 June 2015. 233, 18 September 1862, page 5. Carat From Our Own Correspondent, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 19, Issue 1782, 6 April 1863, page 6. Carat Provincial Council, Hawke's Bay Herald, Volume 6, Issue 376, 11 April 1863, page 2. Carat Nelson Examiner and New Zealand Chronicle, Volume 22, Issue 37, 25 April 1863, page page 2 carat Military and Volunteer Movements, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 19, Issue 1869, 14 July 1863, page 3 carat The Defence Force, Wellington Independent, Volume 17, Issue 1895, 16 July 1863, page 2 carat Military and Volunteer Movements, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 19, Issue 1870, 15 July 1863, page 3 carat Taranaki Herald, Volume 12, Issue 585, 17 October 1863, page 2 carat Hawke's Bay from Our Own Correspondent Napier, 17 July 1863, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 19, Issue 1876, 22 July 1863, page 3 carat Local Intelligence, Hawke's Bay Herald, Volume 6, Issue 406, 29. July 1863, page 2 carat Local Intelligence, Wellington Independent, Volume 18, Issue 1897, the 21st of July 1863, page 2 carat Appointments, Wellington Independent, Volume 18, Issue 1970, the 15th of October 1863, page 3 carat News of the Week, Otago Witness, Issue 622, the 30th of October 1863, page 5 carat House of Representatives, Tuesday the 3rd of November 1863, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 19, Issue 1966, the 4th of November 1863, page 4 carat Disbanding the Defence Force, Wellington Independent, Volume 19, Issue 2121, the 29th of October 1864, page 3 carat Imperial v Colonial Troops Question, Southland Times, Volume 1, Issue 74, the 18th of November 1864, page 3 carat Parliament of New Zealand, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 20, Issue 2298, the 1st of December 1864, page 5 carat On the Defences of the Colony, Nelson Examiner and New Zealand Chronicle, Volume 24, Issue 51, the 29th of April 1865, page 3 carat Coastal Defences, Colonist, Volume 9, Issue 916, the 13th of July 1866, page 5 carat Notice to the Coast Natives, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 19, Issue 1885, the 1st of August 1863, page 4 carat New Zealand Gazette, Daily Southern Cross, Volume 23, Issue 3209, the 29th of October 1867, page 4 carat Retrieved the 20th of December 2010 carat Teanga, New Zealand Ministry for Culture and Heritage Te Manitou, Roberts, John McIntosh, Retrieved the 2nd of November 2016. Carat changes afoot for Special Operations Command PDF Army News New Zealand Army July 2015 p. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Military of New Zealand Rolfe, James Chapter 1999 The Armed Forces of New Zealand Sydney, Allen. VE New Zealand Defence Force Royal New Zealand Navy New Zealand Army Royal New Zealand Air Force Civilian Administration and Oversight, Ministry of Defence New Zealand VE Leadership of the New Zealand Defence Force Chief of Defence Force Vice Chief of Defence Force Chief of Navy Chief of Army Chief of Air Force Commander Joint Forces New Zealand VE Military History of New Zealand Timeline of Maori Battles Musket Wars New Zealand Wars World War I World War II Malaysia Korean War Vietnam War New Zealand Army Royal New Zealand Navy Royal New Zealand Air Force